So what is the objective of this next half an hour? I have only one objective, that how to make sure that you guys don't receive this letter in your lifetime. Because it doesn't, it's a very painful feeling when you receive that. Agree? But if you analyze, if you or if I analyze in last 16 years, those people who received this letter, there is a way they react to this letter. Right? Now, the first very common way of, you know, imagine for a moment if I receiving this letter, the first very common, I open this letter and I will say, is it I? I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Why I'm receiving this letter? Agree? That is the first very common reaction. But unfortunately, you need to validate whether you are really doing good or not. You should not be under your own illusion that you are doing good. Number two kind of reaction which I have seen, which is very common, they will start blaming. Boss is not good. HR is not good. Company itself is not good. They'll start blaming. And sometimes they blame the incidences. I was doing good, but only reason I left, I received this letter because I come late. Oh, I did this mistake. I did big blunder. I've never seen people receiving this letter because of mistakes. I've done huge mistakes in my life. I remember in my division, there were almost 1,000 people and we were launching one brand. And my boss came to me and he said, Praveen, you should send SMS notification to all these 1,000 people that we are coming with this brand, coming with this news. I said, sir, before we send this SMS, we should send a teaser SMS. And he said, okay, go ahead, do whatever you want to do, but send this SMS. And I sent the SMS. In next 1 hour, you are going to receive a message which will excite you like anything. But I did a small mistake in that message. In the word message, instead of E, I wrote A. So it was like, in next 1 hour, you are going to receive a massage which will excite you like never before. I did a lot of mistakes. I remember that day, Manthan was sharing one mistake. What was that mistake, Manthan, where you...
Protein X, the brand launch of...
No, not this Takaiser, your previous organization.
The database was wiped out.
Something which you burned? You saying that I burned something? No? So, this mistake, you got a letter for this mistake? You will never receive a letter just because, just Panchamani did a mistake. Will she receive the letter? No. She will never receive a letter. You will never receive this letter just because you are doing a mistake. HR might use this mistake as a reason to give this letter to you, because what happened in previous last 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, they might use reason, but the reason, the main reason is never the mistake. So first is, of course, people react, why I'm doing good. Second is they start blaming. Third they do, which I have seen people doing this, imagine that, you know, you're working in a team and someone is working and you will say, hey, कुछ नहीं होता यहाँ पे, ये मिलता है. कुछ भी कर ले, यू डू एनीथिंग, एंड ऑफ द डे यू विल रिसीव दिस. वॉज नॉट नेसेसरी, यू हैव रिसीव्ड, मींस दैट पर्सन विल रिसीव. नाउ दिस इज हाउ सम पीपल रिएक्ट व्हेन दे रिसीव दिस लेटर. एट द सेम टाइम लीडर्स रिएक्ट डिफरेंटली. इमेजिन फॉर अ मोमेंट दैट इफ यू आर अ लीडर एंड इफ समवन इज इन योर टीम इज नॉट परफॉर्मिंग, if there's a huge gap between expectation and delivery, huge gap, leaders, team leaders react differently. Few team leaders will just ignore. Imagine if you have 4 people, they will give all the work to 3. And this guy is, okay, theek hai, mujhe kya farak padta hai, don't give me. They will start ignoring it. Or they will start giving more pressure. It's a different way I've seen. What I'm sharing with you is that what I've observed in last 10 years of my corporate job. I've seen people also reacting to this. I've seen leaders also reacting to this. But how to ensure that you don't get this letter? It's just like in entrepreneurship, when people say, 95% businesses fail. There's a study from Oxford University that 95% businesses fail, only 5% they survive. So what is more important to learn? How to manage failure or how to become successful? Because your chances of failing is 95%. So here also your chances of getting this letter is very high. Just because if you are not getting this letter today, that doesn't mean that you will not get this letter tomorrow. I'm not talking about whether you are in Takaizer or anywhere in the, because I have seen people who are considered best today, same people were not considered best, or they were considered average or poor after a few days. So let's learn from those people who have not got this letter. I've seen a lot of people who have never got this letter. Fortunately, many people I have seen. I'm not talking about me. I'm talking about many other people. So one thing which I have seen common in all those people is this. They understand the meaning of this. Lacks. Not money. Right? Unfortunately, many people, when they start their career, their dream is to get 1 lakh per month. Even I had. Right? I still have that dream. But when I started, it's like, but the meaning of lack is not this. Let's understand this word lack. If you understand this, I'm very sure that you will never receive this letter in your life. Can I have a pen, please? Come on, please. Give me a marker. Huh? Throw. Yeah, keep it. This in case this doesn't work. So let's understand before we go on. Let's make a team. What exactly happens when someone receives this letter? So we need 4 volunteers. Okay, so we got 1. So we got 2. We got 3. So we got 4. I'm telling you, yesterday I was, you know, dreaming about this session, so I think plus minus, these are the only 4 people. So come here. Now, because he is a leader, we'll make him a default leader. Correct? Okay? Now, there's a team. For example, this is your team. Now, on day one, when you start, you're always like a family. Take this. 1 minute. So, you hold it, right? Hold it, relax, yep, I relax. Now everything is calm, composed, relaxed, everything is good here now. There is a harmony, right? No tension, no one is pulling anyone, correct? Now, let's imagine that he is the person who is going to receive the non-performance letter. Which I'm very sure not, because the way this guy has evolved, I'm telling you, I must use this opportunity to tell, when he came and today where he is a completely different person. We should clap for him. Right? Done? Now relax. Now, these are the 3 people, according to me, represent those people who never got non-performance letter. And this is the one person, according to me, just an example, who received non-performance letter, correct? What is the difference? The difference is only this. He believes that whatever he has, whatever skill set he has, is the best. Which is okay. And he is happy with his skill set. He is ready to stay where he is right now. Come here this side. Now you get inspired by her. You also believe in learning. You also believe, okay, if she can make it in 2.5 days, let me learn something. I will make it in 2 days. You come this side. Right? You lead. Right? Then you are moving, you stay. You moving. Move that side. Move. You guys move. You go with your leader. You all are learning. Now stop. Bye. Now suddenly you can see a harmony there. You guys are relaxed. You are working. But there's something very stress here. Can you see stress here? Right? There's a stress here. Then he will react. He will react, hey, why me? Oh, my boss is not good. Or HR is not good. He will not change. I've seen people not changing it even after getting the non-performance letter. Jeb mein leke ghumta ho resignation. Boss, who is asking you whether you have the resignation in your pocket or not? We are telling you, you are not matching the expectation, boss. We are telling you that people are moving. Doesn't matter even if you are the best. Today's best, maybe tomorrow's average. Then what will happen? Go that side. You all are moving. And then, it's too much of stress. Now what is happening? He is actually pulling the whole team back. The team is not growing because, see, we are human beings. In last 2 years, you know, he has a family, he has EMIs, he has responsibilities. You have empathy towards him. We are, end of the day, we are human beings. You will not understand from HR perspective that in last 3 years, he has not changed, but his salary has changed. His resources changed. Expense changed. A lot of things changed in last 3 years. He has not changed. You have empathy, then you might come little closer, you might go. Then this will either increase, and sometimes it increases so much, then only a few things will happen. Either the HR will come or will say, it's enough, and you, and it's painful. When someone goes, it's painful. I mean, someone goes, when anyone going from your team, it will be painful for you. We miss that person. It's painful. And then he will say, come on, I will go to some other organization. But I tell you, in last 16 years of career, if you are not changing, this will happen with you again. Leaving the organization is not the solution. So what is the solution? So before I share my learning on this, that why you should not be left alone and why you should not have that pain, you guys have a seat first before I tell you. I think, please have a seat. So how to ensure that this should not happen? For that, the first thing which we have to understand, which will also help you to earn lakhs, is the L of LACS. That is learning. But it's very important to understand that what we learn. Learning is just not, I'm coming to office and my boss is teaching me. My boss is teaching me. I've spent two hours with my boss and today we had a training. That is not learning. I'm telling you, that is not learning. That learning is not going to help you really grow in your life. That is something which everyone is doing, boss. Every corporate is organizing training sessions. Learning is not the responsibility of the company where you are working. It's your responsibility to learn and apply in that organization and that help that organization to grow. Just sitting with your colleagues, just looking here and there, and aaj main bahut seekh gaya, bahut seekhne ko mila mujhe aaj, that's not learning. Learning has to be organized. I remember I was watching a TED talk that day, and this guy, he's one of the leading surgeon from US. Leading surgeon. This guy said, I was under the illusion that I am the best surgeon in the world. And then one day I realized that all our education, almost 22 years, we are always under a teacher, we are always under a coach, and moment we leave the college and everything, we are just without coach and trainer. Sports is the only exceptional where you can't live without coaches. Is there any sports where we can't, where we perform without coaches? Unfortunately, the reason why people fail in entrepreneurship and even in profession is because they stop appointing trainers and coaches for them. Learning is not about ye jo hota hai yahan pe. If you are in a product management team where the Excel sheet or management of Excel is the key, go outside and learn. I remember when I joined product management team, I belong to a very small city, so my English was so poor. From Nasik to Satara, Satara to Karar to Ratnagiri, Chiplun, and I could not, there was no opportunity only to speak in English in that part of the world. So my English is very poor. But when I joined product management team, I thought I have to learn English. So I joined English speaking classes when I was around 28 or 29 years old. I still remember coming from that Mumbai Central Sipla, getting down at Bandra, and when I went for the first time to that English speaking classes, that lady asked me, what do you do in your life? I said, I am a senior product manager in company. And she said that we have three types of courses. One is basic, one is advanced, and one is for executive. You should join executive course. I said, no, my problem is basics. I have to learn basics. I accepted that. I learned. Very sarcastically, on the day one, the child who was just sitting beside me was just 15 years old. He said, sir, I thought you will go on the stage and teach us. That's painful. That's embarrassing. Learning is painful. Learning is embarrassing. They used to give us homework. They used to give us videos where we need to watch those videos. And I remember the lesson was how to use did and didn't. Right? There are a lot of people, they do mistakes. It's always, I didn't go. People say, I didn't went. My son does that. So that day my son was asking me, Dad, no, every time when I do this mistake, you point out, and I've never seen you doing this mistake. Why you don't do this mistake? I said, no, I remember. I was when I was in my first organization, I took a break from my work for 15 minutes. Like we have a break, so I had a break for 15 minutes. So I went to one conference room, and I started a video on YouTube, when to use did and when to use didn't, which no one expect you in a corporate world to learn all this. And I was watching that video, and I closed that. After 15 minutes, I closed the lid of my laptop. And I went on my desk, just the desk like this. And if you see a YouTube video, even if you are offline, when you just open, sometimes it starts. Right? And I reached my desk and I opened the laptop, and suddenly the lady started saying when to use and when to use didn't. I got embarrassed. It was a very painful moment for me. It's like, what to do now? People are, my colleagues, all are saying that Praveen has gone for 15 minutes learning that. When to use and did and when to use didn't. But when you have this kind of painful moments in your learning, you will never, I will never do in my life that mistake. But that's learning, that's painful. If your learning is not taking your time, energy, money, resources, that's not learning. What you are getting here, your boss telling you all this is a luxury, boss, that will not ensure that you get the, you will not receive the letter. So if you are in a coding, boss, you have to spend time, energy, money, resources going Sunday, Saturday, overnight work. Three years ago, when I was realized that I'm a poor speaker, I cannot speak in front of people, I joined Toastmaster clubs. You know, she's standing there. Initial 6 months, every Sunday, I used to go to Toastmaster club for half a day, 24 weeks. That's painful. Living family, even after a hectic week, 6 months continuously I went. How many of you are going Sunday's classes, and especially with the skills which is required for your growth? So the first thing, you have to find out things which is required in your learning. If you are not learning, if you are not spending your time, money, energy, resources for learning, I'm telling you, you might be doing very good now, but my objective is not here. My objective here is to how to ensure that you don't get this letter in your lifetime. Number one. Number two, no matter how what you learn, but if you don't apply that learning, it has absolutely no meaning. I have learned many things in my life which I never able to apply. For example, you know, I used to solve Rubik's Cube. I spent nights to learn Rubik's Cube. Oh my God. I went to mountains, and at 17,000 feet, I solved Rubik's Cube. Today, give me the Rubik's Cube. I can't solve it. I've forgotten it. Because there is no opportunity for me to apply that learning. So if you are selecting learning, whether it's an Excel sheet, whether it's a data, whether it's HTML, whether it's a sales training, whatever, if you're selecting learning, make sure you select those learnings which you can apply in your day-to-day life, in your personal life. Otherwise, there's no logic of learning. Third thing is, if you are not consistent with your application, you know, I apply for 2 days, 3 days, 4 days. You have to be consistent until it becomes your skills. For example, last 3 years, I was consistent with my public speaking efforts. Right? I closed the door. I don't know, maybe whether it's audible or not audible. Sometimes for one line, to say one line, I take five, six retakes. I'm consistent with my efforts. Right? If you are not consistent, consistency is the key. There is a, you know, that day, you know, I was just sharing with, you know, Dolly. There is a girl in our society, and we have been watching that girl for almost last 1 year. That girl is little overweight, and last 1 year we could see that girl taking a half an hour walk every night. Now, even if she is consistent with this for last next 10 years, it's not going to change anything, I'm telling you. Just walking for half an hour is not going to change anything. So it's very important that if you are consistent, but consistent with what learning? Maybe you are consistent with wrong learning. That's why once you learn from correct people, at least you are sure. Imagine for a moment that same girl learning from some expert ki what I should do to reduce my weight and then become consistent in that. Then the person will get the results. Just becoming consistent, main roj aata hu, main roj kaam karta hu, main roj aata hu, main roj kaam karta hu, that is not consistency. You have to be very clear that, okay, I'm learning from the expert, I'm applying in my life and I'm consistent until it becomes my skills. Moment you do this, then I'm very sure you will never receive this painful letter. Because trust me, this letter is not only painful in receiving, this letter is also painful in sending.